Recording.
So viewers, we're going to have a blast on the motorway now. We might even get some filtering because there's normally a traffic jam around this time of the night as road works on the Zurich bypass. Traffic by the looks of it as well, looks busy. And I've not had no news on my Trident yet, and we're on day three now. So now we've got 16 degrees, so we've got all the heating off. So here we go under the bypass. When you turn this corner, you don't know what you're gonna get. Oh, flowing all right. No speed warning signs. Where you gone, mate? Come on! Now he's gonna come back in again. Let's watch. He's wanting to. kilometers of juice left, and we're going to do about 75. Here we go. Here's the speed sign. It means there's trouble ahead. It's a nice colour. I like the little Fiat 500s, they look canny. Wallace had one of them and it was alright. Now the thing is, how the hell do we get this fuel cap off? Because it was keyless as well. Oh shit. Can we see the traffic ahead? I'd start to pile up at the first tunnel. Ah, shit. Do a bit of filtering on this big tall bike. And of course you get one that's just gently coming at the middle and one's just going along the lip. Jesus Christ, man, get across the bloody road! Bah, you awkward twat! Around the outside of this one. I don't know what this would be like to ride with the big panniers on the back. Yay. You know, look in your bloody mirror, man. You're probably sitting with your bloody indicator on. Look at your own lane. So it's been a long day today. Out of bed at 2:40. To start at 5 o'clock, finished at 3. Last flight was Emirates A380 aircraft. God, I can't believe the car that's next to us, don't know what the hell it is, some American thing, higher than the bloody car. Car screeching up behind, bloody hell, man. Gives you the willies. Come on, Frenchie, get your skates on. Si vous plaît. Of course, we're on a Swiss motorway, which the maximum speed limit is 120 kilometers an hour, which we're just coming to here, end of the restriction. So we can't really open this up, but oh, it's windy though. The wind catches the fairing, the screen a little bit. Whoa, bloody hell. But I suppose it's a big bike, so it's quite stable, you know. That's not an American car, it's a Honda. Oh, a Japanese then. So it is quite a windy day, and I am getting buffeted, I have to say, from side winds. And but I am pretty well protected, I have to say. We're doing 80 miles an hour and it's no hassle, you know. I think I could just sit on this all the way to Calais. Jump the tunnel and up in the Island of Dreams. As I said in one of my earlier videos, this bike is really easy to ride. And I think anyone would like to ride it, even in new riders, old riders, no matter monkeys. It's a comfortable ride. I don't know what I can say. There's nothing else I can say that has never been said before about the GS. It's dead comfy. It has road presence, that's for sure. Seems quite good on fuel. I don't know what the hell it might tell me on here. If we go that way, let's have a look. Consumption. I don't know when it was set. If it was set when it was new, it's done, what, 1146 kilometres, and it's at 5 litres per 100 kilometres. Know what the hell that means in sensible language, but get your calculators out and work it out. So for a UK gallon, it's actually knocking around the 4.5 litres, isn't it? So 100 kilometres is approximately what, 60 miles, somewhere around that. What's what we want? Just under 50 miles to the gallon? Something like that, eh? I just don't. Oh, I don't know. My heat scrambled after a day at work. There's a lot of shit going on with this screen, but I'm kind of getting used to it. It is, obviously, I can only compare it to my Trident. The information that's on this screen, I think, is set out better than it's on the Trident. You know, because everything is separated, the times. And the miles per gallon is one place, and you've got something else and something else. Nothing kind of get together on the Trident. Oh, slow down, Jesus Christ. See, all these tunnels are closed in the morning when I came to work this morning. God, his lights are bright. Has he got a bloody main beam? Bloody hell, I think he's on main beam and knob. I say the only thing I kind of found not to be liking on here is the little switch at the back of here from knocking from dip to main beam. You have to keep knocking it backwards and forwards, I think there's a pain in the arse. Car's right up my ass. So see, the next thing he'll do is the fuel cap. How the bloody hell do we open it since it's keyless? So we'll have to figure that out. Oh, bloody hell, slow down. We'll have to figure that out when we get to the fuel stop. How are you, mate? Stay there, car, stay there, stay there. Oh shit, what now? Not bloody customs again. Oh, they had a massive queue yesterday here because there was German customs on the border. Sitting waiting here forever. Front of that bloody truck. Keep going, keep going, keep going. It must be customs on the board. What the hell were they looking for, man? You know? They're out of summit. That was like my old Beamer. You already? Or 75 or whatever it was, I can't remember. Many moons ago. This has got a hold feature, I'm not sure how it went on, but it's canny. What time is it? 15:49. 10 to 4, bloody hell. Shit. Hello?
Hello, this is
Cooley
from BMW Gottschalk.
Okay.
Hi, I wanted to call you because of your Triumph. Yes.
Yeah.
And they said we
should
Okay,
do you want me to call into your garage tomorrow after I come back from work? Okay. Because I'm actually riding back right now from work, because I work in Zurich. Yeah. Okay. Oh, question. I'm going to put petrol in. How do I get the fuel cap open? Yes. Okay. Okay. Okay, that's cool. Okay. Thank you very much. Okay, cool. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, and your GS, wow. It's the best thing I have ever ridden. Oh, it is fantastic. Okay, mate. Okay, thank you very much for the info. Bye-bye now. Bye. So why are the queues not here? Ah, okay. Pull them over. Of course, people stopping to have a gulp. It doesn't bloody help. Some folk just give them to a ship, man, you know. Oh, there's a bit of bother on the road. Let's stop and have a look, eh? Surprised I haven't got the friggin' camera up, man. So that was Triumph on the phone there. They're going to do some... They've done a lot of testing on my bike, seemingly. They've replaced quite a few parts, seemingly. So we'll find all this out. And they're going to replace another part, Triumph have said. So, we'll get the full gist of it. Maybe it's tomorrow. So he says, just keep the bike. Just keep our bike. Just keep it. You're not getting the bugger back. So he tells us how to get the fuel cap off. My eldest, unfortunately, she's had a long day at school today. I think she started at 10 to 8 this morning, and she finished at 3:15. So she'll be knackered. Oh, there's a hold on again. I wonder how I put that on. It's good, isn't it? Aye. Things I'm finding out before I give the bike back, eh? I'm getting used to dancing between tiptoes on both sides. Oh shit, what's that? Must be cable. I mean, bloody cable's not long enough. I have to be careful how I turn my head. I'll rip the cable out. Surprise, it hasn't got a stop-start system. I don't know how I put the hold on. Ah, there we go. Now. From 2 this morning to 18. So that's a 16 degrees jump, eh? So I'm going to get some bikes to test. Obviously I have to pay for it, for the daily rent myself, like, but even so, it'd be nice to put some videos out about the different sorts of bikes if I can, with my grumpy old man opinion. My youngest said yesterday, can you get a scooter? Can we try a scooter? Oh, I thought, Jesus Christ, a bloody scooter. What am I going to do with a scooter? But then again, why not, eh? I always get one of them bigger ones, the 500s or the 600s. Ones that got a bit of clout about them, eh? But I've never been on a scooter. Well, I wonder what's for tea when we get in. So there's about 32 miles left in the tank. I've still got 2 bars on the fuel gauge. Like, I have to say, I like a fuel gauge with a lever rather than the bars, you know. Because you can kind of see, you can see the lever, you know, or the pointer. But with the bars, you never know when it's going to drop to the next bar. So I think my next test bike will be, because rent a motor rod, they do some rentals and they've got a they've got three, God, that cable's tight, man, three motor goodsies. So I'll see which is a compatible one of this, because I think they've got one like this, and give it a shot and see what it's like, eh? As I said, I'll pay for it myself to provide my viewers with content. Ah, the kids can do without food for a day or two. Oh, how do you get your skates on, man? Oh, you're not going to dawdle all the way back, are you? Folks got places to be, you know? Beastie inside me bloody visor. Jesus, get out. I never like me beasts, I never like beasties. I'm a right wuss as far as beasties gone. Forgot some people don't wave to BMW drivers, riders. Imagine that at Gotstein's, the Triumph dealership, if they take me a Chinese belly pan off, eh? And falls to pieces. They'll think, what the hell is this shite on here? At least there's bikes. I've got the bike, the GS, for free. Apart from the 10 euros a day extra insurance I took, just in cases. Ah, you can at least nod your head, you twat. Oh no, when we get the monkey back on the roof. You see the gap where it sits? Some bloody solar panels there, like. Yeah, well, how do you get your skates on, man? Oh, must be digging for gold there. There we go. Whoosh with the wind. Chicken George, chicken van outside the supermarket. People my age might remember who Chicken George is. Stick down in the comments if you can remember Chicken George. How much is juice here? 2.9, eh? Gotta say, it's a hulk getting your legs over. So ignition off, everything's off. He said that the fuel cap should just rise. Oh, it does. Oh, okay. It does. I didn't pull it far enough back. E5, it does take, yeah, E5 it says.